some khuluq ismu al-haya. Khuluq ismu al-haya. Haya, right? We can say it's modesty, we can say it's shyness, but in Islam, there is no meaning for it, except long sentences. Let me define it for you in a simple way. Al-haya, an la yajiduka Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala haythu nahak, وَأَلَّا يَفْتَقِدَكَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى حَيْثُ أَمَرَكَ. Haya is to not be in a place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to be, or to not be in a place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be, and to be in a place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to be. Yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be here at the time of the prayer, and you're not. You have no haya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to sit with people who backbite, and you are. You have no haya. Yesterday, I tested you, the whole school, and I found out that you have haya, all of you, mashallah. Can you imagine that? Say takbir then. No, I said say takbir. Allahu Akbar. Now it's my turn. Takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Awesome. Yesterday, remember before I said, should I trust you to pray the sunnah at home, or should I not trust you and raise your hand, and those raise your hand will go and the other one will stay? You can fake that, you can say that. So I wanted to test in a different way. Yesterday, what did I say? If you don't want to pray the sunnah, just go ahead and you're dismissed. I personally did not see a single person leave. That's haya. Why? Because you were shy, even though you might want to leave, and you have the permission to leave, you were shy to leave and not to be looked at as you did not pray the sunnah. That's the haya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Anytime Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given a lecture. Three companions came from that door. The masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, open area, covered with palm trees, leaves and such. So it's open. So you can come from that exactly like this and go through. Three came. One of them, he looked, oh, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving a lecture, so he came all the way, looked for a gap, and sat as close as possible. The other one, he shied to keep going, so he sat in the back. The third one did not care, just kept going. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained to us the three situations. He said, "Amma al-awwal." فَآوَى إِلَى اللَّهِ فَآوَاهُ اللَّهِ. As for the first one, he took shelter deep with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like the people of the cave. What did they do? They went inside the cave. إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةِ. So they're covered. And this person, or this sahaba radiallahu anhu, came and he came close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really covered. As for the second, he shied. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shied from him. Don't start going with your mind and compare. Remember when we said shine. Shine, oh, by the way, did you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his qualities is haya? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Allah hayyun sittir. Yastahyi idha rafa'a al-'abdu yadayhi yad'uhu an yaruddahuma sifran kha'ibatayn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has so much haya that when you raise your hand asking him for something, he has too much haya to not give you what you're asking and make you go back empty-handed. That tells you what? Make dua. You will definitely get what you want. If you're really attentive with your heart, you will get it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has haya, so much haya. In fact, you see the haya on his face when he sees something bad. His face changes red. Like he sees someone cusses or says a bad word, his face changes red. Why? Because you're not supposed to do that. Remember, you should not be in a place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to be. And you should not listen to something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to listen to. And you should not look at something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to look at. And you shall not walk to something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to. Hand is the same thing. So handshake, boy, girl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you. So if you shake, you have no haya. So when he sees something wrong, his face changes red. Unlike the faces of us, it changes red when you're embarrassed. Like I come and say, for instance, what's your name, Shah? Mu'min. I come, Mu'min, come here. I want you to give a talk. And his face changes blue and green and purple and all of that. That's not the haya that we're talking about. Haya, one time he asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba, he said, Atadruna mal haya? You know? They said, yeah, we know, you know. He said, I'm not talking about that. Haya, an tahfad al-ra'sa wa ma wa'a. To safeguard your head and what it contains. What does your head contain? I mean, besides no brains, we know that, but we need something different. Ears, eyes, nose. How can you protect? How can you have haya in your nose? See, application of Islam. It's not just relearn it and come and tell me you don't know. How do you have haya in your nose? Huh? What did he say? Smell alcohol? Yeah. A lot easier than that. If a woman passes by wearing perfume, you don't smell and you don't say, what do you expect me to do, Sheikh? You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the nose so you can smell. You know, what should I hold my nose? Yes, hold your nose. Slow down, walk different way. There are solutions if you want to go to Jannah. The road for hellfire is wide open. It's actually bigger than the freeway. You know the easiest way to go to hell? Who knows, for a dollar. I'll say it, be at one word. One word. Erfa. No. Be? No. Start with why. Huh? Who? Who said it?
She said it.
10 people. Who said it? Alina. Alina. I heard it from this side. Did you hear from there? One person to answer. Tell us, huh? Didn't go. I need to put three up. Brother, you want to steal it? It's for her. Jazakallah khair. There's one there. But who was first?
Yeah, right.
Alina always. Have you ever watched baseball? Why do baseball players spit too much? Right? They fix their hat and they spit. They're not paying for the TV, you know, you're paying for it. I didn't think I would go that far, mashallah. Okay. So, Sheikh, Woodward. Well, Hamza, mashallah, it looks like. Hamza, ta'al, give us a speech over here. You talk too much. Wow, now he's. I test you sometimes, honestly. This is good. Wallahi, I felt so good yesterday that you did not leave. Because it gave me the feeling, yani, even if you don't, you worry about yourself, and you want to be associated with good, and you don't want to be associated with bad, and that's a good quality already. When you shy from being in a bad place, and you shy not being in a good place, even if you don't feel like it, look at that companion. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was shy, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has haya to not to reward him. Even though maybe he wants to keep going, but he did not feel good just walking when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he still got rewarded for that. That's how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to not do good only, to associate with good. Imagine if a person sitting here with us, and he is not really paying attention, or doesn't really, he's not sitting just to listen to me. But he came with one of your friends and said, he is blessed with you simply because he is with you. And he has no good intention to be here. But because you're blessed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know how, give an example. You know how sometimes I come to you, and you're sitting together eating or something, and I take a handful of almonds and just throw it on everybody, even though there are some people who don't deserve it. And I know they don't deserve it. But instead of coming giving, I'm too generous to start pick and choose. I just go, let them have it. If a human being can do that, what do you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If he gives you the whole world, it's not equal to a window of mosquito. That's why it's so good to be with good people. When the blessing comes to them, it comes to you too. And it's horrible to be with bad people, because when the punishment comes to them, it comes to you. Unless what? Unless you're there making da'wah. Always, always associate with good and disassociate yourself with bad, and always have the khuluq of the hayat. Always don't be missed out where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects you to be, and don't be where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to be. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. 2 rak'ah, quietly, jazakumullah.